As you prepare for the final assessment for the novel Out of the Dust, remember that that final assessment is based on your poetry analysis group activities. You worked in four different activities where you and fellow students analyzed poems from Out of the Dust. You asked yourself a number of questions and reported on them. The last analysis assignment, number four, was graded by me based on the rubric that I will use to grade the final assessment. You should take a look at those results and identify areas where you should improve before that final assessment. In this video, I will discuss those areas so you can understand how to improve and prepare for the final assessment. You will look at two documents during this video, and as you look at them, you may wish to pause the video to address the documents. You should look at the model example that I am looking at now. You should also look at your poetry analysis number four, and that will show you your areas that need improvement. You will also see my feedback. In the bottom of that document, you will see pasted the poetry analysis rubric. This rubric reflects all the tasks that you must complete for the poetry analysis, including summarizing the poem, discussing its pacing, discussing its mood, discussing a figure of speech and identifying its function, discussing other poetry devices and discussing their functions, and annotating the text. Let's look at each of those in turn. Through this video, I will explain how I would have completed each of the tasks. As I explain, feel free to pause and take notes. Reflect on what you have done and how you could have improved. Do this to prepare for the final assessment. Let's start with summary. The summary task requires you to summarize the poem, but also to fit it in context. You cannot truly summarize a poem or a chapter from a book for anyone unless you understand how that fits into the overall story. So the summary task is actually two tasks, and this is reflected in the rubric. Let's read my summary statement about rabbit battles on pages 6 through 7. In the novel, the dust storms have been destroying crops for a while, and the people of Oklahoma are feeling the harms. This portion of the summary reflects what is going on in the novel at the time. I have stated to the reader where this poem appears in the course of the overall story. In this poem, jackrabbits come down from the hills because they are starving. They raid the crops farmers are trying to grow. The men go out to kill rabbits in large numbers with clubs. Billy Joe comments on how some of the men bet on how many rabbits they can kill. She seems sad at all the rabbit deaths. This is a complete summary of the poem, does not add too much detail, but definitely covers the entirety of it. Students sometimes only summarize a portion of the poem, missing important developments. Be sure to summarize the entire poem, and be sure to do both tasks. Make sure you're fitting the summary into the context of the overall novel, and summarize the poem in its entirety. Students often complete this second task quite easily, but also often fail to complete the first one. Make sure you are fitting the poem into context, as well as summarizing it in its entirety. Remember, if you need some help in reminding yourself of this, the rubric expresses it. A 3 on the rubric indicates that you have summarized, but you have not fit it into the context of the novel. Make sure that you are scoring a 4. Let's move to pacing. Pacing can be a challenging concept for students. Pacing depends upon line length and punctuation, and it refers to the way a speaker would speak the poem when delivering it. For rabbit battles, you can see that I have discussed the pacing as varied. So I begin my discussion by making a conclusion statement. The pacing is varied. Then my discussion presents evidence. Evidence from the poem that indicates my conclusion of a varied pace. Students often conclude the pacing, but do not provide the evidence. Be sure that you are doing both. Let me read mine. The pacing is varied. Many lines are short, but many are medium length. The lines range from 1 to 10, this referring to syllables. The stanzas are roughly the same length, averaging 11 lines each. Punctuation appears, but not regularly. Thus, the reader would read fluidly and smoothly at times and pause at other times. This keeps the pace varied, so the reader should not pause overly much, but should also not rush through. This is a complete discussion of how the poet would read the poem, and it provides some indication of evidence. If you think that evidence is general and not very specific, then we will refer to further discussion of evidence through annotation later on. But right now, this is sufficient for the pacing discussion. So for pacing, be sure that you indicate what the pace is and provide some evidence for how that pacing conclusion was derived. Let's move to mood. The mood discussion is a discussion of the emotion built by the poem. It's pretty easy to identify mood, but just as with pacing, you want to identify some amount of evidence or explanation for how that mood is developed. Let's take a look at mine. Billie Jo is developing a mood of resentment and anger. She criticizes the men for their violent and competitive behavior. The images of dead and skinned rabbits supports this feeling. Notice that I have identified the emotion, resentment, and anger, similar emotions, but I am very clear in stating what the emotion is. Most students stop there, without providing evidence. Be sure that you are moving on to providing evidence. Billie Jo's criticism and the image of violence both indicate resentment and anger. I will discuss this further in annotation, but this is complete for this section of the assessment. Be sure that you are doing both tasks. Identify the emotion and provide some discussion or evidence for how that emotion is developed. Let's move on to figures of speech. Figures of speech often challenge students not in identification but in explanation. Students can often identify a personification or simile or metaphor or even a symbol. However, students often simply identify it and do not discuss. This leads to lost points on the rubric. Be sure that you are doing both, identifying and discussing. Let's take a look at my example. Hess writes, "Sick to my stomach," which is an exaggeration. This is my figure of speech. Billie Jo is not actually sick to her stomach. This exaggeration helps convey her anger. I have given some indication of what the exaggeration is doing, how it functions. I've said that she is not actually sick to her stomach and that the exaggeration emphasizes her anger. This shows an impact of the figure of speech. All figures of speech do something. A metaphor will do something. A simile will do something. It is not sufficient to identify the presence of one of these figures of speech. You must actually identify the impact, and that is often more important. So, if you have identified a metaphor, make sure that you explain why Hess has used the metaphor in the poem. If you have not identified why, then you have not fully explained the figure of speech. Be sure to do both. If you look at the rubric, you will see that in figure of speech, an accurate identification with a failure to discuss is a 2 out of 4. Be sure you are doing both. The same holds true for other poetry observations. Other poetry observations include poetic devices and conventions not covered by figures of speech. In mine, I discuss repetition. Hess repeats Mr. Noble and Mr. Romney at the beginning of the first and third stanzas. This keeps the focus on her anger toward those men. The repetition of scowling in the third sentence emphasizes the harsh mood. I have not simply identified the repetition, but I have also identified the impact, keeping the focus of anger and intensifying the anger. So it seems that both moments of repetition focus and intensify the angry mood. Notice how my impact here with repetition relates to my mood above. If you are properly conducting poetry analysis, observations in one place will often relate to an observation in another place. That shows that the poet has some sort of coherent strategy that builds a given purpose. When you are discussing other poetry observations, do this in the same way as you did figures of speech. Be sure to identify the poetic device or convention, but also identify its impact. Make sure that you are fully explaining by doing both of these tasks, and notice that the rubric for other observations is very similar to the figures of speech rubric. Now let's look at the text itself. In the assessment, you should see the actual poem. Notice all the annotations. Annotations are comments made about the poem, identifying sections everywhere from a word to a piece of punctuation, all the way up to series of lines. Your annotations should be ample. The original assignment asks you to include at least 5. For the final assessment, I am raising that number to 6. You should include at least 6 annotations, but here is the problem. Students often include annotations that do not say much. Often they include annotations that merely comment on something that is going on, providing personal opinion of the student, or merely summarize, restate what's going on in the line or in the section. Your annotation must focus on some sort of poetic observation. Notice my first. Hess splits Noble and Romney because they experience conflict. This refers to a line split, a line break, which is an aspect of poetry. Here I'm talking about the lack of punctuation, making the pace smooth. Remember above when I discussed how my pace evidence was not exactly specific? That's because my annotation makes it specific later on. Notice here that my observation on the word revenge is how the word revenge is harsh and builds that harsh mood. Each of my annotations throughout the document expresses and discusses some sort of poetic convention. Be sure that you are including at least 6, if not more, annotations that refer to words, phrases, lines, stanzas on a poetic level. Do not simply summarize, and do not simply repeat what Hess has already written, and do not merely give your opinion. Remember that this is poetry analysis, and continue to discuss the poetic devices. That's the entirety of the rubric. You'll notice one last criterion, though, excellence. I have included an opportunity for 2 bonus points if the student analyzes in such a way that demonstrates intense mastery of poetic devices and discussion of poetry. The final assessment score will be 28 points. However, this opportunity for 2 bonus points will push certain students above. So be sure to throw yourself into it. You will have approximately 40 minutes to complete this poetry analysis, which should be plenty of time to cover all aspects of the rubric. If you have questions, remember that we will discuss this in class. But in the meantime, review your notes. Everything on this assessment is open book, so use those notes and your past examples clearly to succeed in your poetry analysis.